You are welcome to today's Sunday school. Shall we pray? Father, help all your children who are married to keep their spouses to the end. Deliver our marriage institutions from collapse. As many homes that are troubled, Father, we pray because of today's lesson, let there be restoration, let there be peace in such homes. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. Our topic for today says divorce and remarriage. Divorce and remarriage. Lesson 35. We shall quickly go over the lesson we had last Sunday. That was lesson 34. And the topic was marital unfaithfulness. We said marital unfaithfulness is the failure of one or both of the couple to keep their marital vows. It is not being dedicated or committed to each other. We looked at some of the causes of marital unfaithfulness in marriage, such as failure to provide for the basic needs of the family, lack of respect for the word of God, and to their marital vows, lack of contentment, bad company, evil association can result in marital unfaithfulness. And we said some of the solutions to marital unfaithfulness is for couples themselves to learn to satisfy one another sexually, to have room for the word of God, and they must appreciate one another. Today, we are going to divorce and remarriage, and the Bible passage is taken from Matthew chapter 19, 3 to 12. Matthew 19, 3 to 12. The Pharisees also came unto him, tempting him, and saying unto him, is it lawful for a man to put away his wife for every cause? And he answered and said unto them, have you not read that he which made them at the beginning made them male and female, and said, for this cause shall a man leave father and mother, and shall cleave to his wife, and they twain shall be one flesh. Wherefore they are no more twain, but one flesh. What therefore God hath joined together, let not man put asunder. They say unto him, why did Moses then command to give a writing of divorcement and to put her away? He saith unto them, Moses, because of the hardness of your hearts, suffered you to put away your wives. But from the beginning it was not so. And I say unto you, whosoever shall put away his wife, except it be for fornication, and shall marry another, committed adultery. And whoso marrieth her which is put away doth commit adultery. His disciples say unto him, if the case of the man be so with his wife, it is not good to marry. But he said unto them, all men cannot receive this saying, save they to whom it is given. Verse 12 and the last verse. For there are some eunuchs which were so born from their mother's womb, and there are some eunuchs which were made eunuchs of men, and there be eunuchs which have made themselves eunuchs for the kingdom of heaven's sake. He that is able to receive it, let him receive it. Amen. And memory verse is taken from Malachi chapter 2 verse 16. Malachi chapter 2 verse 16. For the Lord the God of Israel seeth that he hateth putting away, for one covereth violence with his garment, saith the Lord of hosts. Therefore, take heed to your spirit, that ye deal not treacherously. According to the Bible, marriage is a lifetime commitment. As we see in Matthew 19:6, where Jesus says, wherefore there are no more twain but one flesh. Marriage is a long time, it's a lifelong commitment. To protect the rights of divorce, of divorcees, especially women, God laid down some laws in Deuteronomy chapter 24, verses 1 to 4. However, Jesus pointed out that these laws were given because of the hardness of people's hearts, not because such laws were God's desire. You see that in Matthew 19, verse 8. Therefore, it is important to remember Malachi 2, verse 16, that is a memory verse, that God hates putting away. God hates divorce. The pain, confusion, and frustration most people experience after a divorce are surely part of the reason that God hates divorce. Even more difficult, biblically, than the question of divorce is the question of remarriage. In our lesson today, we shall be studying the biblical position on divorce and remarriage. To do this, we have two lesson outlines. Lesson outline 1 says, grounds for divorce. Lesson outline 2 says, grounds for remarriage after a divorce. Lesson outline 1, what is divorce? It is putting away one's spouse, as we see in Malachi 2, verse 16. Next question, are there any biblical grounds for divorce? Yes. Number 1, instance of sexual immorality. As we see in Matthew 5, verse 32, and Matthew 19, verse 9, where Jesus says, and I say unto you, whosoever shall put away his wife, except it be for fornication. Except it be for fornication. That is, for sexual immorality. Biblical ground says there might be a reason for divorce. Secondly, instance of abandonment by an unbelieving partner. We see that in 1 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 15. It says, where an unbeliever wants to depart from a believer, let him go. However, God has called us to peace. God has called us to peace. What are the first steps to take whenever there are issues in marriage? For example, if there are problems in marriage before problem of separation and divorce sets in, what are the steps to take whenever there are issues in marriage? The first steps comprise confession, forgiveness, reconciliation, and restoration. At what time or level is divorce an option, though hated by God? When confession, forgiveness, reconciliation, and restoration have failed. Next question says, are there other reasons or grounds on which people seek for a divorce? That is, are there any other grounds apart from sexual immorality and abandonment where people seek for divorce? And the answer says, yes. The grounds are abuse of spouse, physical or emotional, child abuse, addiction, pornography, drugs, alcohol, criminal activities, finance mismanagement, gambling, threat to life, and so on. People do seek divorce on some of those grounds. Should a couple remain in marriage when there is threat to life of either of the spouse or a criminal intent? There has been cases where a spouse kills the other partner. The question is, should a couple remain in such a marriage where there is a threat to life? And the answer is no. Separation for some is appropriate under such instance. That is, when there is a threat to life, separation is appropriate for the spouses so that there will not be threat to life. Why is separation for some and not divorce a welcome development? And the answer is to allow for repentance and restoration. Sometimes couples are separated so that there might be time to solve the problem. There might be time for either or both of them to repent, and then the marriage will be restored. Next question, why should divorce be considered as the last option when there are issues in marriage? Why should divorce be the last option? And the answer says, because God hates putting away, that is, God hates divorce. As we have read in Malachi chapter 2, verse 16, God hates divorce. What is the duration of separation? And the answer is, separation could be short or long, depending on partner's willingness to repent and change his or her way. Or it might be both of them that needs to repent and change their ways. So, there is no definite time for separation. It could be short, it could be long. It depends on their willingness to repent and to change their ways. Lesson outline 2 says grounds for remarriage after a divorce. Question 1 says, what are the exceptional clauses which suggest remarriage in the Bible? Number 1, there is fornication. As we see in Matthew 19, verse 9, it says there, and I say unto you, whosoever shall put away his wife, except it be for fornication, and shall marry another, committeth adultery. And whoso marrieth her which is put away, doth commit adultery. So there, even though Jesus mentioned the case of somebody divorcing a partner and remarried, he did not approve remarried there. He says, whoever marrieth the one that is divorced also commits adultery. And also, in 1 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 15, 1 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 15, it says, but if the unbelieving departs, let him depart. That is, in cases where an unbeliever is married to a believer, or maybe two of them married as unbelievers, and one partner becomes a believer, and then the other partner does not want to stay. Apostle Paul was saying here in 1 Corinthians 7:15, he said, but if the unbelieving depart, he does not want to stay with the believer, he said, let him depart. He says, a brother or a sister is not under bondage in such cases. But then, he says, but God has called us to peace. Is there any phrase in the Bible that suggests remarriage? Yes, Jesus said, and marries another. Is sexual integrity part of the marital bond? Is sexual integrity part of the marital bond? Yes, God sees the two partners as one flesh through sexual relationship in marriage. He said the two of them shall become one flesh. So before God, a husband and a wife, they are one. Ephesians chapter 5 verse 31 says, for this cause shall a man leave his father and mother and shall be joined unto his wife, and they two shall be one flesh. They shall be one flesh. So sexual integrity is part of the marital bond before God. The next question says, if one spouse is an unbeliever and continues to be, can the believing spouse continue the marriage or depart? The answer again in 1 Corinthians 7:15 says, it applies, says that the believing spouse can exercise the option to depart if his or her life is threatened. Between divorce and making peace with the other partner, which one does God support? Will God support divorce, or will support making peace with the other partner? The answer is found in 1 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 15, the C part, which says, but God has called us to peace. So God supports peace, not divorce. He supports couples making peace rather than seeking divorce as an option. Is there any reason why it is sometimes good not to marry, according to 1 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 1? Yes, to allow such person devote attention to the things of God without distraction. Some people might choose not to marry because they want to be sold solely to the work of God. So, they might decide not to marry. Is there any connection between death of a spouse and remarriage? The answer is yes. The surviving spouse is free to remarry another believer. In 1 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 39, 1 Corinthians 7, 39, it says, the wife is bound by the law as long as her husband liveth. But if her husband be dead, she is at liberty to be married to whom she will, only in the Lord. So when either of the spouse dies, the other partner is at liberty. He is free to remarry, but only in the Lord. He or she should marry a believer in the Lord. He is no longer bound by the law. He can remarry. In summary, God's factor is paramount in all cases of remarriage, so that the intended partner will not offend God and the Spirit. As we see in our lesson today, God hates divorce. Rather, He has called us to peace. So divorce is not an option for believer. But as we have seen, where there is threat to life, separation might be recommended, but the separation is for both partners or either of the partner to repent and be reconciled back, and that the marriage be restored. God hates divorce, and the Bible says, whoever marries a divorcee commits adultery. And so, divorce is not an option. God has called us to peace, and remarriage is only biblical, as we have seen this, in the case of a woman who is free from that law, who is no longer bound because the husband is no more alive, or the husband is no more bound because the wife is no more alive. They are allowed to remarry, but only to believers. Conclusion: regardless of the ground for divorce that Christians might have, a couple can, through God's grace, learn to forgive and begin rebuilding their marriage. Shall we pray? Father, please sustain our marriages with genuine love. Marriages that are going through turbulence, or couples that are considering divorce or separation, Father, we pray for such couples today that because of this lesson, they have learned that God is divorce, and that they will repent, they will confess, they will forgive each other, and they will have to start reconciliation, and that their marriage shall be restored. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. God bless you.